My name is Kevin Pieris, and today I will be talking about mode field diameter. So what is mode field diameter as it relates to fiber optics and testing? And so that's kind of what I'm going to cover today. So a little bit of a primer, to kind of get you to understand exactly what I'm talking about. It is important to understand that there are different types of fibers out there. And so with the different types of fibers that we have out there, you know, based on the ITU standards, over here to the right, we have basically the, the standard names that we use, because we don't often say G.652.D, right? And so we'll say standard single mode fiber or something like that. So these are kind of the generic names over here on the right. So most of the fiber that we deal with today, a lot of it is G.652. So standard single mode fiber, this is the predominant single mode fiberglass that we use in fiber optic networks across the world. And so obviously there's different versions of this, but we'll call this standard single mode fiber. And then we have G.653, which is dispersion shifted fiber. It was optimized for 1550. We don't use it for DWDM at all. So this glass is essentially not being manufactured anymore and suffers from some issues, some nonlinear issues, so we don't see it much. G.654 we see a lot in the submarine environment. And then G.655 down here is non-zero dispersion shifted glass. So if I zoom back out here so you can see the different fibers and the types, non-zero dispersion shifted fiber. So it's optimized for DWDM transmissions is what that's for. So you see a lot of this on the longer distance transport systems that are doing a lot of DWDM. And then G.656 glass, it's also a DWDM glass, but has a lower dispersion slope, so you can take advantage of more of the channels. And then down at the very bottom, the other glass we'll be talking about quite a bit today is G.657. There's different categories of that. This is basically bend insensitive fiber. So today during my quick presentation here, I'll be saying standard single mode fiber, and we're talking about G.652. And then I'll say bend insensitive fiber, and so that'll be G.657. So those are the types of fibers that you have out there. When it comes to G.657, this is bend insensitive fiber. It can handle more of a bend radius without exhibiting attenuation on the longer wavelengths. And so this is a great graphics from ITU here that, you know, kind of compares the different categories of G.657 or bend insensitive fiber along with standard fiber up here. And so standard single mode fiber, about a 30 millimeter bend radius, where if you get all the way down to bend insensitive fiber B3, you can get down into 5 millimeter bend radius before you start exhibiting macro bending issues. And so this is really important to understand, right? So that's, you know, that's the, you know, the two different kinds of glasses that we'll be talking about today. Because we're seeing it, a lot of folks right now are splicing bend insensitive fiber to standard single mode fiber. And so we'll talk about how that looks on an OTDR trace. So what exactly is mode field diameter? Great question. So what exactly is mode field diameter? Mode field diameter is essentially the area of a fiber that the light travels through. And so it's often confused with core size. It's often confused with core size quite a bit. Core size and mode field diameter are not the same thing. They're not the same thing at all. Core diameter or core size is essentially just that, the size of the actual core itself of the fiber. You know, the 8.3 microns for standard single mode fiber typically, right? That is core size. Mode field diameter is the section of the fiber that the signal travels through. So a bulk of the signal obviously travels through the core, but in the longer wavelengths, we actually travel a little bit in the cladding, a little bit in the cladding itself. So that's the difference here between the two. And so to kind of give you a better graphic of it, over here on the left, we have standard single mode fiber, right? So we have standard fiber here on the left. We have bend insensitive fiber over here on the right. And you can see the different mode field diameters that we have here, right? So up here in the top is the mode field diameter size. At 1550, it's 10.4 microns. We're at for standard, and for bend insensitive is 9.65. So you'll see there that there's a difference in the mode field diameter, so this area of the fiber the signal travels in. So in standard fiber, our longer wavelength, like 1550, will travel a little bit more in the cladding than it will with bend and sensitive fiber. And if you look at the core sizes are essentially the same, right? They're essentially the same, 8.2, 8.3 microns, whatever, you know, that type of fiber that you're deploying. And so, you know, to give you an idea of that, you know, this is, you know, having similar core sizes here, right? So the core size between bend and sensitive and standard fiber is essentially the same. It is the mode field diameter that differs, right? It's the mode field diameter that differs between the two fibers there. And that's what's important to understand, you know, when you're looking at the fiber itself. So when we look at the mode field diameter of one versus the other, you see there's a mismatch there. So we call this mode field diameter mismatch. Let me get my head out of the way there. So we call this mode field diameter mismatch, where standard fiber has a larger mode field diameter than bend and sensitive fiber, right? And I just noticed there's a typo down there. This should say bend and sensitive. It should not say standard. I'll have to fix that in the deck. And so if you look at an OTDR trace, depending on which direction you're looking at. So if we're looking from a larger mode field diameter, standard fiber, into a smaller mode field diameter, bend and sensitive, we will get what we call a gainer. So we get a gain in power at this splice. Obviously, there's no such thing as a gainer in a passive element like this. This is because when we travel from one mode field diameter to the other, the backscattering changes a little bit, the properties of it. And so it looks like to the OTDR that we have, you know, this spike or gain in power when we do not. And so that's what we call a gainer. From the other side, you'll get what we call a loser, so an exaggerated loss. So this is important to understand, because if you're only looking at your trace from one direction, you will not get a good idea of what the loss is. Both of these values are not going to be accurate from one direction. The only way to get accurate measurements for this is to look at it bidirectionally. So take the gainer from one direction, take the loser from the other direction. The software will basically add them up, divide by two, and then give you the average loss of that splice, which would be much, much more accurate. So if you look down here to the bottom left, that will zoom that out. From A to B, we have a gainer. And then from B to A, we have a loser, and they average out to a decent number. If you only look from the one direction, it looks like an exaggerated loss. So that's what I wanted to give, you know, give you an idea of that, right? And so, you know, putting this into practice. So understanding how this matters as it relates to an OTDR, here's what it looks like. So I have an OTDR trace up here on my fiber that I have here in my home office. And so a lot of you, you know, probably recognize I shoot the same fiber in all my training here, right? So I just did a quick trace using good resolution. So fairly short resolution in here. But essentially what I want to do is I want to show you what a mode field diameter mismatch looks like. I don't have one at a splice, but I do have one here at a connector. So essentially what I have coming here is in this section of the fiber right here at about 182 meters after my launch cable, I have a gain in power. See that? A gainer of 0.105. This is a gainer. And anywhere where there's a gainer on one side, there's going to be a loser somewhere on the other side. So wherever it changes back, you know, to the you know, mode field diameter. So essentially what I have going on here in this particular network, you know, to give you an idea, this section of glass right here, this section of glass right here is standard Singlemode. So this is standard Singlemode fiber. And then right in here, it's kind of hard to see. I'll zoom into it here in a second. I have bend insensitive fiber. In fact, it is B3 fiber. So that 5mm bend insensitive fiber there. And then I go back to standard fiber here as well, right? So the rest of this is all standard fiber. So I only have about maybe 20 meters or so of bend insensitive in here. So let's see what that looks like on the screen here. So I'm gonna go ahead and zoom into that. And you'll see here, you know, what I'm talking about. So we see the trace coming in, and then you look, this is higher on the power scale. So that means we have a gain in power here. And then this is the loser coming out of the other side here, right? This is the loser. So here we have a gain in power here, and then here we have a loser, It doesn't necessarily have to be the very next event for the loser. And this one, it happens to be because I know my network. But this could be miles and kilometers down the line before transitions. We see a lot of this when going from bend in, standard fiber to bend insensitive, or even going between the same fiber types. So they're both standard single mode fiber, but one's buried and one's aerial, and one was manufactured 10 years ago, you know, as opposed to the other. And so those difference in dates, there might be a slight variance within, you know, the manufacturing tolerances of core size and mode field diameter. So I often see that. So if I see a span that goes out and then comes up and then goes for a long ways and then eventually comes back down, this tells me that there's a good chance there's a change in fiber type, buried to aerial, bend insensitive to standard, whatever. So you'll see that kind of big plateau that sticks out, you know, when you zoom in far enough. In this case here, this is what our gainer and loser looks like. This is from that mode field diameter mismatch, right? This from that mode field diameter mismatch. And where we most commonly see mode field diameter mismatches in today's networks, at least this is what I'm seeing a lot here in the US. But basically where I'm seeing this the most is transitioning from your inside plant fiber to your outside plant fiber, or from your feeder fiber to a drop and those types of things. So it's not uncommon to see within an office nowadays a change in fiber type coming out of your office. So essentially, let's say they're in the office and we have a lot of pre-terminated FTPs being deployed. So modular FTPs that are already pre-terminated on one side. And so essentially, you know, you place that modular FTP inside of your site, and then coming out of that, you'll have a feeder fiber of predetermined, like a tail, that will splice into your transition. So all of this out here is your OSP cable, and then this is the tail that comes off of that modular FTP. And it's not uncommon for this to be bend insensitive fiber, you know, just because of risers and fiber management issues. And then in the OSP fiber, this is typically standard single mode fiber as well. So now you have a mode field diameter change, right? So you're going from a smaller mode field diameter to a larger mode field diameter. And so what's gonna happen here is you're gonna have a loser. So this splice here will be a loser. So an exaggerated loss. So this one's gonna say, hey, you know what? This splice is 0.3 dB a loss. And if you look at it from one direction, you're gonna flag that as, you know, possibly bad. We're also seeing bend insensitive fiber on drops. So you can order your drops that are coming off of your terminal into the, you know, over to the home. These can be bend insensitive as well. And so on this side here, you'll have a gainer coming back, right? So you have a gainer coming back because you're going from a larger mode field diameter again, still, to a smaller. So this is gonna give you your gainer going this direction. And so you'll see your, you know, your negative 0.15 dB or something like that, right? So loser in one direction, a gainer in the other. If you're testing in reverse, this is gonna be a loser and this is gonna be a gainer, right? So of course you take these two values and then basically add them up and divide by two, right? And that gives us our average. And so, you know, so the average is what we want. We want the average splice loss, and that's what it'll tell us here. You know, that's kind of it in a nutshell, right? That is mode field diameter mismatch and where you'll see in your network. You'll also see this as well, obviously splicing from the other types of fibers. So going from G.652 standard fiber to non-zero dispersion shifted fiber, like the transport fiber, you'll see a mode field diameter shift there as well. But this is what I see the most in the field today, is bend insensitive being spliced into standard fiber. And this is something that that really needs to be understood. This is just part of the physics, but it's important to understand what this phenomena is. My name is Kevin Peary with EXFO. Thank you very much for your time.